Hi, this is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. I'm going to show you how to create a simple but powerful album portrait from a photo. Open a photo you'd like to use for this project. I downloaded this one from dreamstime.com. Go to Select and Color Range. Click Highlights. Drag the fuzziness and the range all the way to the right and click OK. This created a selection of the white and lighter areas of your image. Invert the selection by pressing Ctrl or Command Shift I. We'll cut the selection from our image and copy it to its own layer. Press Ctrl or Command J. We want to make a new layer below the active layer. To do this, Ctrl-click or Command-click the New Layer icon. We'll fill the empty layer with white, but first, if your foreground and background colors aren't black and white respectively, press D on your keyboard. Since white is our background color, press Ctrl or Command plus Delete. For this example, I want to hide the hair on the left side. If you want to mask out areas on your subject, click the top layer to make it active, and click the layer mask icon to make a layer mask next to your cutout subject. Open your brush tool and brush picker. We'll take care of the size in a moment. The hardness is 0% and the opacity and flow are both 100%. Then press enter or return. To make your brush bigger or smaller, press the right or left bracket key on your keyboard. Brush over the areas you want to mask out. To zoom into areas, open your zoom tool by pressing Z on your keyboard and then drag it over the area you want to zoom into. Press B to open back your brush tool, adjust its size, and continue to brush over areas. To reposition your image, press and hold the space bar and drag it. Then open back your brush tool and continue to brush over areas. To fit your image back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. Click the top layer to make it active, and click this icon to lock the transparent pixels. Doing this allows us to fill the cutout with colors without filling the transparent pixels. Open your gradient tool and make sure the linear gradient icon is active. Click the gradient bar to open the gradient editor. Click noise for the gradient type. The gradient contains randomly distributed colors. The roughness controls how gradual the transitions are between color bands in the gradient. I'll keep mine at the default amount of 50%. By dragging the sliders in the red, green, and blue components, it'll adjust the colors within those components. If you don't like the existing gradient, no problem. Just click Randomize to show various gradients until you find one you like. Then click OK. Click and drag your cursor across your image at various angles and locations until you like what you see. If you notice some areas of white that weren't masked out completely, click the layer mask to make it active, open your brush tool, and brush over those areas. If you want to slide your subject to the right or left, open your move tool, and make sure Auto Select is not checked. Press and hold Shift as you drag the image in either direction. To crop your image to a square aspect ratio, you can use your Crop tool or open your Rectangular Marquee tool, go to a top corner, and press and hold Shift as you drag it over your image. If you want to slide the selection to the left, just press and hold the left arrow key on your keyboard. Go to Image and Crop. Then deselect it by pressing Ctrl or Command D. Next, we're ready to add text. Open your horizontal type tool and pick a font. I'm using a font called Little Lord Fauntleroy Regular. If you'd like to use it as well, I provided this link in this video's description or project files. I'm using a size of 95 points, however, you may want to adjust this amount depending on the size and resolution of your document, as well as the amount of characters in your text. I'll choose left alignment for this example. The color is irrelevant since we're going to replace it with the noise gradient. Click on your document and type out your text. To reposition it, open your Move tool and move it. Before we add the gradient to the inside of our text, we need to rasterize the text. Go to Layer, Rasterize, and Type. Click the Lock Transparent Pixels icon. Press G to open your gradient tool and drag it over your text at an angle you like. Next, we'll create a graphic flare under our text. Click the New Layer icon to make a new layer. Open your Single Row Marquee tool and click below your text. Go to Edit and Stroke. Make the width 5 pixels and the location center. Click OK and deselect it. Click the Lock Transparent Pixels icon. Open your Move tool and drag the line to a position that works well with your text. Open your Gradient tool and drag it over the line. Next, we'll fade out the line as it gets closer to the right edge of your album cover. Click the Layer Mask icon to make a layer mask next to the active layer. Click the gradient bar, and this time, click the black-white gradient. Then click OK. Place your cursor approximately this far away from the edge of your album cover, and press and hold Shift as you drag the gradient across approximately this much. Notice that your line has faded out. Next, we'll warp the line into a graceful graphic flare. Press Ctrl or Command T to open your Transform tool. Click the Warp Transform icon. Place your cursor on the right anchor point and drag it straight up and at an angle. Go to the left middle anchor point and drag it down a little bit so you can see the other anchor point that's directly above it. Go to that anchor point and drag it down. Go back to the first anchor point and drag it back up to its original horizontal position. To see all the anchor points, we need to zoom out. One way to do this is to press and hold Ctrl or Command as you press the minus key on your keyboard. Continue to play with the anchor points until you have a shape that you like. Then press Enter or Return. To fit your document back onto your canvas, press Ctrl or Command 0. This is Marty from Blue Lightning TV. Thanks for watching.